Cloudy water is annoying. It seems to come out of nowhere. The cause is hard to identify. It looks absolutely terrible. And if it gets too bad, it can kill every living thing in your aquarium. If you've dealt with this in a previous aquarium, you already likely know what to do. But for the rest of you, Matthew here, your BRS beginner guru, and I'm gonna teach you how to get rid of cloudy water. First off, we need to distinguish between two types of cloudy water. The first is fine particles like sand. If you're setting up a brand new tank with a new bag of sand, there is a 100% likelihood that you'll have cloudy water. This is why bags of Arriga Live from Carib Sea come with a water clarifying pouch. But this sort of cloudiness is super easy to fix. The second type of cloudy water is caused by a bacterial bloom. This often happens during a new tank's nitrogen cycle, but then also at seemingly random times in established tanks. How to tell the difference between the two? Well, this one's actually pretty easy. If you just added sand or stirred up your sand bed, then you have particulate cloudy water. But if your tank was clear yesterday and you did absolutely nothing to it and today it's cloudy, you likely have a bacterial bloom. Let's start with how to get rid of cloudy water caused by particulate matter. This is most common when adding new sand to a new tank. While definitely ugly to look at, in the short term, it's really not doing any damage to your livestock. The easiest way to get rid of this is just by using mechanical filtration and changing it frequently. For me, the standard BRS felt filter socks do the job nicely. The trick here is to change them out at least once a day, maybe even more than that. When I'm setting up a new system, I always make sure to have my wave maker on, and then on that first day, I change my filter sock 2 to 4 times. All I do is I pull it out, I rinse it with some fresh water, and I put it back into place. And then on day 2, I'll use my flipper magnetic algae scraper to clean the glass because a lot of that fine particulate matter that comes in a bag of sand seems to be attracted to the glass and can give the whole tank an overall cloudy look. You may still notice some cloudiness hanging out near the bottom of the tank, and this will just take a few days to disappear. If you're adding a sand that comes with a water clarifying pouch like Arriga Live from Carib Sea, definitely add that as soon as you add your sand bed, as it will help clear up your tank within a day. But if you're using dry sand or sand from a different company that doesn't come with water clarifier, well then you can use a flocculant like Seachem's Clarity. This is a trick I actually use when setting up brand new systems that I then need to film the same day. A flocculant works by taking smaller particles and clumping them together so that your mechanical filtration can catch them. But when using Seachem's Clarity, you'll need to change out your filter sock or replace other mechanical filtration a lot in the first 24 hours because the flocculant goes to work almost immediately and is pretty fast acting. Moving on to a completely different type of cloudiness in your aquarium, this one is caused by bacteria, and we commonly refer to it as a bacterial bloom in the hobby. The single largest danger associated with a bacterial bloom is suffocation. During a bacterial bloom, the white cloudiness that you're seeing is actually a bajillion heterotrophic bacteria, the same bacteria that consumes excess fish food, waste, and other decaying matter. The problem with having that many beneficial bacteria in your water column is they can outcompete your fish, coral, and other inverts for limited oxygen in your tank. And if that occurs, then you're left with a bunch of dead livestock. But what causes it and how do you get rid of it? The most likely cause of a bacterial bloom is some sort of organic imbalance in your tank. Maybe the day before you did a huge vacuum of your sand bed and kicked up a whole bunch of old fish food and waste, while at the same time disrupting all of those beneficial bacteria that lived in that sand bed. Well, the beneficial bacteria that's left go into a reproductive hyperdrive to consume all of that freshly discovered organic material and replace the colonies that you disturbed when vacuuming the sand bed. Or maybe one morning you get up and you can't seem to find that prize tang anywhere in your tank, and the next day you come back and your tank looks like a hazy fog has taken over. You then put 2 and 2 together and realize your tang is likely dead, so all of those beneficial heterotrophic bacteria are populating your tank like mad to consume all of that organic matter. Whatever is causing the bacterial bloom in your system is likely caused by organic material of some kind. So then how do you get rid of it while also protecting your livestock? Well, the easiest way is just to increase surface agitation to get more oxygen into your tank, and then Just wait. Flocculant won't work here, and water changes may seem to help in the short term, but then the cloudiness will almost always return with a vengeance. If there's an obvious cause like a fish death, then you should take care of it and remove the dead fish. But really, it's just a waiting game. The heterotrophic bacteria are multiplying for a reason, and that's to take care of all of that new decaying matter, so once the underlying reason has been dealt with, the cloudiness will clear. Just be sure to keep oxygen in the tank via a lot of surface agitation. I'd recommend getting a separate wave maker and pointing it up at the surface of the water at least until the cloudiness starts to dissipate. But what if you're impatient or you start to notice livestock distress, like your fish gasping at the surface or your snails rolled over on their side? There is a faster solution which works really quickly, it just doesn't address the underlying issues that are causing the bacterial bloom. A UV sterilizer is a surefire way to clean up the bacteria bloom quickly. The most annoying thing about a standard UV sterilizer is they can be a bit of a bear to set up and they take up a ton of space. But if you're just dealing with a bacterial bloom and don't intend to install it long term, then one of these hang on the back UV sterilizers from Aqua UV is a perfect solution. You just hang it on the side of your tank, attach some flexible tubing to a correctly sized utility pump, and you'll have clear water within a day or two. Just be sure during that time you address and fix whatever that underlying nutrient problem was so the bacterial bloom doesn't just come back. Cloudy water is a definite annoyance, but one that usually cures itself on its own with some time. But yellow, stinky water does no such thing. Click here to learn how to install an ozone reactor to never have yellow, stinky water again. And as always, everyone, thanks for watching. Happy reefing, be well. We'll see you next time.